I'm Lisa Raleigh, and this is your Wake Up Call. Keep it real, powered by Ned Group Life. Let's make it happen. There are so many myths when it comes to burning fat more effectively. And today I chat to Mari Walters, a registered biokineticist, and she's going to help me to bust them all. Mari, what is body mass index, or BMI, and why is it so important?
Your BMI is basically your weight divided by height squared. And what we do is we work out a range for a healthy weight. Now, that range is usually between 20 and 25. But what it doesn't take into account is your muscle mass and your bone structure. So unfortunately, some weightlifters and rugby players out there aren't too happy with their BMIs.
So 20 to 25 is desirable. What happens then after 25?
Okay, anything between then 25 and 30 is overweight, and anything above that is obese.
What's the best way to lose weight? Is it cardiovascular or weight training?
Definitely a combination of the two. For cardiovascular work, working at a good intensity will be burning fat. All right. However, doing some resistance training with that, you actually increase your metabolic rate. So doing those exercises, you might not be using as much energy as you would be using during cardiovascular work. But afterwards, when we're sitting on the couch, when you're working in the office, you're actually using up that energy. So that's a good way to ensure that you get the most out of exercise by combining cardio and some strength training.
Working in your fat burning zone used to be the craze. Is that still the case?
I think it's important to note that when exercising, you're burning energy, you're using energy. All right, in order for you to do that, you're actually using up calories. So let's put that equation. Energy equals calories. In order for you to burn a lot of calories, you need to work, and working in that fat burning zone, you need to work for a really long duration to actually get the most out of a session and to actually utilize fat as such, as a fuel source. However, we've realized that when you're working at a really nice high intensity, you can burn that amount of calories in a much shorter space of time, which is exactly the problem these days, the fact that we don't have as much time training.
Do you continue to burn calories after an intense workout?
Absolutely. Because of your high intensity, you're actually using those calories for a longer duration after your training session than what you would have just working in your fat burning zone. Working in a fat burning zone, you would have utilized it, and then once you've stopped, you would have stopped utilizing that energy.
Most of us these days don't have long periods of time to exercise. So what would be the most effective way to train to burn fat?
A good idea would be interval training. So after you've done a proper warm-up, work at a nice intensity, really sprint it for say 2 minutes, and then you reduce your intensity slightly. We call it a recovery session, and then you repeat that up to 5 times.
So that'll give you a 20-minute workout.
Exactly. You will get a good workout that way.
Mari, please bust this myth for our viewers, that when you stop exercising, that your muscle miraculously turns to fat. Is that true?
That's exactly it. It's definitely not true. Muscle does not turn into fat, but you will definitely lose your muscle. If you don't work at maintaining your muscle, you will not have it. So it will start to disappear, but it will not convert into fat.
So does that mean that if you've lost the muscle, then your metabolism reduces, but
Absolutely.
You keep eating the same amount as you did when you were training?
That is often why some people will gain weight and be unsure as to what the reason for that is. It's because of the muscle that they've lost, and then their metabolic rate isn't as high anymore. So unfortunately, they're not burning that fat or utilizing that energy after exercise, when sitting in front of the computer, when sitting in front of the TV.
The answer is just to create a balance, and it'll eventually become a way of life.
It must become a way of life. It must be daily activity. It's really important.
And now for today's financial savvy tip. Estate planning is when you structure your assets to ensure that on your death, your estate is distributed amongst the beneficiaries according to your wishes. To find out more about today's show and our featured experts and the chance to win awesome daily and weekly prizes, log on to keepitreal.co.za. So if you're wanting to burn more fat, then remember to increase your intensity and train for shorter periods of time, and you've got a winning recipe. That's it from me, Lisa Raleigh. Remember to keep it real. Until next time. Keep it real, brought to you by Ned Group Life. Let's make it happen.